So we talked to Rich Fulcher, a design-minded developer on the Android team at Google. So he's going to tell us a little bit about personas and use cases and basically blow our minds.
Hi, I'm Rich Fulcher. I started my career with a master's degree in computer science and was programming computer graphics for quite a while. But then I switched over and I became a designer. And now I'm a designer and manager as part of the Android team here at Google. I think there's a huge temptation at the start of a project to just kind of get going and do the thing you want to do the most. You know, when you're a designer, you want to start drawing. When you're a developer, you want to start building out those APIs or start coding or kind of get to that first screen. But you want to temper that. You can do that, and it's okay to engage with that kind of passion you have for what you do. But you also want to make sure that you're building in the right direction. The only way you can do that is to be aware of the users. So you need to start thinking, you know, who is this audience that I'm building this thing for? It can't just be me. It's got to be much bigger than that. So how can I understand them? How can I make sure that the things I'm excited about, these use cases that I'm thinking about, really line up with what their goals and what the needs of the user are? So one way that you can think about users is through the use of a persona. You know, just trying to build out your model of how this person other than yourself, you know, one of your users, just more information about them and kind of what their goals and what their context of use are. When you have those personas, the next step is to really think about, well, how do they act with your product? And one way you capture that, them completing a task, is through a use case. You know, what are the steps they go through to complete a specific sub-goal? So you have your personas and have your use cases. How do they influence the way you treat development? Well, something I do is I try to refer to those personas by name whenever I can, or I try to talk to the specific use cases. And if I'm talking just about myself and my opinions, I'll make a distinction by just repeating the word I. I'll say, well, I think this, to make a clear kind of gulf between what I personally think and what I as a designer representing these personas think should be true.